and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be my pregnancy update. This is my weeks 14 to 15 and I basically am just gonna tell you everything that's gone on in the last week. So I have been feeling okay this week, apart from in the middle I had a really bad spat of food poisoning and I don't particularly know exactly what it was that made me so ill, but oh my life, it was horrendous. And it really put me out for a couple of days, so that was really horrible. And obviously I didn't know like how food poisoning can affect pregnancy and stuff like that, so I texted my midwife and she said just like obviously keep hydrated is the most important thing, and she said that all should be okay. If it doesn't clear up, then obviously contact your GP. So luckily, obviously, after once everything had escaped my body so to speak, I started to sort of be able to keep stuff down. Like I couldn't even keep like a sip of water down. It was absolutely horrific. Vile. I've had food poisoning that bad about 4 times in my whole life and it's just horrible. I just don't know whether I got it because obviously like probably my immune system's a bit lower being pregnant and stuff, and it's just really strange because the people that I went for a meal with ate exactly the same as me, and it was just very weird that I copped it and I didn't. Which is why I just think either I had a bad bit of whatever it was, or you know, it was just that my immune system was not as good. So yeah, apart from that, this week has been all right. I feel like I'm definitely getting bigger. I feel quite big now. I mean, obviously I know I'm gonna be a hell of a lot bigger, but it's like very obvious that I can't fit into, I'm like on the cusp of not being able to get into any of my clothes. And obviously you know my whole story and the fact that I've lost the 5 stone and stuff, and obviously it is psychologically a bit difficult to think to yourself like, you know, there is a reason for this, there's a reason, you know, you're growing a baby. But because I still can't believe it, I'm not just even saying that now, I still even though I've seen the scan, it's like almost as if I feel like I'm watching someone else. Like I just do not believe I'm pregnant. So it's really difficult for you to just get your head around and say, right, Till, come on, you know, you're growing a baby, it's all right, it doesn't matter, like, you know, whatever you put on you can lose afterwards. You know, it's really difficult because it's all psychological. But obviously me losing the weight was worth this happening, as you know, as I'm sure you know, it was really hard work, but it was worth it. But it's just basically getting your brain around to accepting the fact that you are going to get bigger, and not always you know, for the next 9 months or whatever, you're not going to have this body you've worked really hard for, but you've got a baby that you work really hard for, and that's what I have to think. So yeah, I'm on the cusp of not being able to get into my clothes. It's the bottoms that are annoying. Like I've got some floaty tops and stuff that are all right, but it's like my leggings are getting a very tight around my belly, and I've got a couple of pairs of maternity leggings now, but I need like some nice, I want some like nice black like tapered trousers. I need some dresses. It's like I need to go and buy like a whole new maternity wardrobe, because it's not even the fact like I'm that big yet, but it's just you just don't want anything on your belly. It's really weird. So I need to go. It's really annoying as well, because there's so many shops, you can't just walk into a shop and there's a maternity section. I definitely think there needs to be more. Like I remember our Asda used to have a maternity section, even if it was just like pajamas and, you know, a few basics like black tops and white tops and some, I don't know, some black trousers or something. But you know, it's like I really need some black trousers now, and I just like, I know I've got to order them online, and I'm really not the type of person to order clothes online because I just worry about the rigmarole of having to send them back and stuff. So I always like to try things on, but it's just like, I know I've got to order stuff online now. So I'm going to have to do that and bite the bullet and get some stuff. I definitely know the Asda website's really good for maternity stuff. And also thanks for your recommendations on New Look and H&M. I'm definitely going to have a look there as well. So yeah, definitely in need of purchasing some new clothes now, as I've hit 15 weeks now. According to the hospital, I'm 15.2 today, but according to my dates, I'm 15 today. So I'm going to stick with my dates as far as the videos are concerned, but obviously my appointments and stuff, they're going to go off the date that they've put down. So obviously the baby's just measuring 2 days ahead, but or know that that's not possible. Anyway, so apart from all that, I've had quite a few headaches this week, and I've looked into it on my pregnancy app. I've got the, I think it's the NHS pregnancy app, and it says that they just like hormone induced headaches, so it's perfectly normal. I've just woken up, I'm not someone to get headaches a lot, and I've just woken up with a few headaches, and they kind of go throughout the day, and then at night they're sort of coming back, and it's like them ones, you know, when you shake your head and you feel like you can feel your brain and it really hurts. So I've had a few of those this week, luckily none today, but I'm starting, like I'm feeling a bit tired in the afternoons now. I haven't felt tired really for a few days, but I don't know, like the last couple, I mean for a few weeks, but like the last couple of days I have felt a bit tired, but I'm sure it will be fine once the weekend's here and Ed's at home and me and stuff. So that's really how I've been feeling this week. Apart from that, nothing else untoward. So this week we've been lucky to receive a few lovely gifts, and these were from Ed's brother and his girlfriend, which was really, really kind of them. And they saw these and just thought that they'd be really nice for the baby's bedroom. So we've got these like big hardback books, and we've got a Finding Nemo, and then we've got all the Toy Story, so 1, 2, and 3. And I just thought they were so, so nice, like, because I want to get some of those like white floating shelves. I don't know why that's a floating shelf. But I want to get some of the white floating shelves. So you've got them stacked, and like, once we know whether it's a boy or a girl, obviously we could either buy the princess ones or some more of the boy Disney films, and you know, we can get those collected. I think it'd be really, really nice. I love books, and I think it's really important that, like, I mean, I know obviously it'll be a while till the baby can read them, but at least I can look through, because inside, like, it's really, really nicely illustrated, and like the colours and stuff, so like even for the baby to just like look through as they grow through the months, I think they'd be really, really nice. So thank you for those, George and Beck. Then we also received this little set from Ed's mum, which is so cute. It's Humphrey the elephant, and it's got all clouds and, oh no, sorry, it's grey stars and the little elephant on the trousers there. And obviously the, as I said, the nursery is going to be like grey, painted grey, but with like clouds and stars. That's the thing that I want to go for. So like this is gorgeous and like matches the nursery as well. So that is just so, so cute. And it's our 2-year wedding anniversary on Monday. So obviously a 2-year anniversary is cotton. So my nan and granddad got us like a bag of like things like tea towels and aprons and stuff like that. And then she put in these little scratch mitts. They're just like basic scratch mitts, but I like got them out last night and I was like, oh my God, like there's gonna be a baby's hand in there. And I had a mini panic attack. Like, I was like, oh my God, like I just can't get my head around still that it's happening. I really can't. I don't think it's actually going to hit me probably until the baby's in my arms. I just can't, I cannot believe it so much, because I'm just so convinced that it was never going to happen. As I know I keep saying, I'm broken record, but I just can't believe it still. It's so weird. Now, on the subject of that, of gifts, I've had quite a few people very, very kindly ask me if there's anywhere they can send stuff to. And because some of you are just so generous and so kind, you're wanting to send us stuff. And I do not want you to think, I'm not just saying this, I do not want you to think that I'm asking for anything, because I am not. But some of you have been so, so kind asking to send us gifts and stuff like that, which is unbelievably kind. And I don't want you to think that I'm like asking for them at all. But there, I have got an address now, so if you put it underneath, in the description underneath, we have got a separate address now that we can use for if you did want to send us anything, but you do not have to. I'm not saying that, but I'm only saying it because I've had people ask if there's anywhere that I can send stuff to. Regardless of that, I also wanted to say, because obviously I get a lot of messages, but sometimes I don't get time to reply, or I read them and then I think, oh my God, you know, it's like halfway through my phone and I'm halfway through doing something, and then I think, oh, I don't know who messaged me. And there's, as you can imagine, there's over 8,000 of us on here now, and 13,000 of us on Instagram, which is mind-blowing. That's a lot of messages that I do get daily. But I thought we could take it back old school. And I, like, if you wanted to ever write me a letter or anything like that, I will be able to pick them up now with this address. So you can send me letters if you want to. I don't know what you'd say to me, but if you wanted to go old school, proper post, I think it's so nice receiving a letter, and I will try my utmost best to reply to you. I want to get some like nice note cards and stuff like that to reply to, because I want to take the time to thank you and to write back to you, as you take the time for me. So if you do ever write me a letter or whatever, just make sure you put your address in there. If you, I know it's cheeky, but if you definitely, I'll definitely reply if you put like a stamped envelope in there. I will definitely reply. It's just because, purely because, the time it takes for me to go to the post office and things like that. I never ever go to the post office, but even if you don't do that, like, I'll try my best to reply. But if you do put a stamped address envelope in there, it is much easier for me to go and reply to you, and I definitely will. So, but I don't want you to think, this is really awkward, because I really don't want you to think that I'm like asking you for letters or asking you for gifts or anything like that. But it's purely, if no one had asked, I wouldn't have mentioned it. But purely because people have asked, then I will, obviously, there is an address now that you can send stuff to. So thank you very much. It's really, really kind of you. We don't expect anything at all, but thank you very much. It's really, really kind, because I value a lot of you as, you know, all of you as real friends, and, you know, you just take the time to watch me, and I want to take the time to thank you as well. So yes, the address is down below. So I'll just show you the bump update. Oh god, it's getting, and I have had lunch today, so I probably look even bigger, but there you go. I mean, like, I've just had lunch, it's getting there, but even if I suck in, there's not really a lot I can do there. It's like all there. And it's definitely, I'm feeling some funny flutters on the nights now. I definitely think I can feel something. So it's really nice. But we've got like the heartbeat, like midwife appointment, not next week, the week after. Beginning of the week after. And then the end of that week, we've got the gender scan. I'm so excited. Can't wait to find out what it is. So a lot of you have said girl, and a couple of you have said boy. The majority of my family are convinced that it's a girl. I don't know how I feel. I think I'm swaying more towards girl, but then I had a dream last night, it was a boy. I really don't know myself, I really don't. But going off the scan picture and the nub theory thing, like what you guys have said as well, has convinced me more so to girl. But I really don't know, and I really don't mind. I just cannot wait to find out. I'm going to start waffling now. Thank you very much for watching, as always. Thank you for all your comments as well on my vlogs and my hair as well. I've got it straight today, and I never ever have my hair straight. I always have it curly, and I think I look way younger with it straight. It's really weird. So I'm going to get the curlers back out. But thanks for all your comments. I do read them all. I'm just so sorry. I don't have a lot of time to sort of reply to them, but I do read them all, so thank you very much, really kind of you. And yeah, so I will see you very soon, and yeah, just leave me a comment. If you do send me a letter, just leave me a comment to say that you have, and I can go and check the box. I'm going to check it like once a week, you know, just check it just in case. But as I say, I want to reiterate, you don't have to send me anything, but it's there if you want to. So I will catch you guys really, really soon. Thank you very much for watching. I love you loads. Bye.